Hi, Barry Young here with part 3 of how to grind tool bits. Today we're going to grind a threading tool. This is used for external threading on round pieces in the lathe. This is a rather large one, it's 1 inch square. We use much bigger ones in industry and much smaller ones at home in our home workshops. Today I'm going to grind this piece of mild steel to make it look like a threading tool. I use mild steel because it grinds quicker here and I won't waste your time. So, off we go. You must have a center gauge like this. Some people call it a fish tail. Center gauge is the correct term. It's not a thread gauge, all right? Now, in this fish tail, right on the end, is a groove, a V-groove. We're going to make this tool match, fit in that V-groove. When we're done, the tool won't go like this or like this. It needs to come straight out of that V. Okay. I usually just put the tool bit right down onto the tool rest and then rotate it 30 degrees and plunge. Now I'm grinding this much quicker than you will to try and make the video short. And that's why my tool bit here is changing color. When I grind a tool for use, I avoid changing color. All right, now I'm going to just flip it over and do the other side exactly the same way. Grind, grind, grind. Now we're getting close. Now I've got it roughed out. Let's check it with the center gauge. See which direction we have to go here. Well, what do you think? Let me take a look here. Looks like we got way too blunt a tip. So, I'm going to find out where I was, and then I'm going to crank it over some more. Make it actually sharper. Okay, let it cool down here a minute. Let's check it. Is that a little better? Looks like there's, now it's a little too sharp. It's got some slop in there. So I'm going to have to grind the tip away. I'm going to find out where I was and just rotate towards the tip. Same thing on the other side. And let's check again. Now we're fitting pretty darn well. It's still a little bit too sharp though. Grind away some more of the tip. Notice I'm leaving it on the wheel long enough to where it makes one solid cut. That's good enough for this demonstration, but in the home workshop you can go until that's perfect. The last face I need to grind is the top rake. So, turn 90 degrees to the wheel. And notice that the shank end is farther than the end being ground. What that'll do is give me an angle like this, or a top rake. And what I'm doing now is grinding until I see sparks coming off the tip. Now, if you're doing soft materials, you'll make this even more pronounced. Like for plastics, you could go as much as this much, 10, 15, 20 degrees even. Teflon, probably 30 degrees. That'll make it extremely sharp. Now, I have a tool that is approximately the correct shape, and I've got the top rake in. The problem is, because I flipped this tool bit over, I don't have the compound angle that I was looking for on each one of these faces. To get that, now I can't be on the tool rest. I lift the tool, line it up, you can feel it when it aligns with where it was, and then lower the shank till you get sparks off the top. Like this. As soon as the sparks come off the top, you know you're there. Do the other side the same way. And once we finish those two compound angle cuts, you find yourself to be the happy owner of a new threading tool. Now, there's some things people do wrong with this tool. Let's talk about that. One is too much slop, which means you need to grind away the tip, as I did earlier. Another thing that they do is what you can see here, faceting. Let's make that one solid grind, top to bottom. And another thing, they don't remove these burrs on the end of the tool. So, you get rid of that burr. And I do that just by working it back and forth, edge to edge. One edge, then the other. Now we have a tool that will cut threads. That's how you do that. Thank you very much.